couches here. It's for certain individuals that we're just going to ask questions, and they're just going to talk about the last 30, 40 years or whatever that we've been in existence in the educational realm here. And that's why we've got all of our staff from Shannon Christian School, Shannon Nursery School, and 3D. Well, you're normally here anyway. But we've even got Brenda and Barry from Boxburg Christian Academy that have joined us here. So I think that was just Holy Spirit led that you just came to our service this morning. So at the end of the service, when we're dedicating all of our staff, you must also come up and be dedicated. So we've got video clips prepared, and the first ministry that we want to look at is our Shannon Nursery School, which is actually where we have it next door on the mezzanine floor, just above the hall there, and that's where we have a nursery school that functions every. Well, Monday to Friday, and we've even got an aftercare there, and that. So for some of you who have been coming to church, that's what happens here at the church during the week, among other things. But there's education happening, and there's transformation in the lives of the little ones that come here. So as the video plays, I just want to ask that Sister Rensha, if you'll come join us on stage, Denise and Margaret, if you'll just come join me on stage. Yeah.
Of such is the kingdom of heaven. Thank you.
Over 40 years of impacting the lives of the little ones, and that means that some of them that started then are now almost grandparents. Is that what we're talking about? But yeah, it's just so awesome just to see those pictures and even the concerts over the years, and it's very special. But we just want to talk about it a bit. I just want to ask Sister Rensha, if you'll just talk to us a bit about when the vision for a nursery school was first released and like the early days of the nursery school, if you can just talk a bit about that with us.
Well, we came to Benoni in 1972, and in 1977, I think it was birthed. Charmaine Smook and Linky de Jong, surnames that time, they bought a property together to make money. But Linky soon found a boyfriend, and you know what that means. It changes your whole life. And she left, and Charmaine was on her own. And Charmaine was teaching that time in Benoni Nursery School. And she felt that she wanted to start in Russell Street. So her dad helped her with the renovations, and they fixed it up, but it had no name yet. But they started in 1978. And then when the church was opened, 79, Pastor Smook and Charmaine had talks together, because Pastor Smook also felt that he was going to open a nursery school. So they talked together, and that time they decided that school will come this way and become one. But the in-between, I had to cart children up and down with a combi. I can't remember why I had to do that. But in any case, I did it. And it took quite a while. And then Russell Street was closed, and it was only this one. And this you actually pronounced Hanan, not Shannon. But it just came about that it was named Shannon. So in 1980, Rachel, who was one of the teachers in Russell Street, and then it closed down, she came and taught here. She started to teach here. And there she's sitting, you can ask her. And she was with us all the time, and many came, and I was involved right from the beginning. We worked hard to get everything going, but the children came. We were registered for 100 children, but it went far over that number. And so it was birthed and opened. Pastor Oliver, does that answer your question?
That's answered a couple of my questions that I've got. But that was great. That was awesome. So, Margaret, your involvement, just give us a bit of your involvement in Shannon or Hanan over the years.
Okay, my involvement started also with to glorify God, because I'd got divorced and I started here the month after that. And that was just a gift to go, from God. It was in 2005 that I started. And I taught the grade R's for 2 years. I think it was 2.5 years, and then took over as principal and have been principal from then on. God has blessed us with every little blessing that he could give us. We always say, and I've always said, that every child that walks through that door is a gift from God. My vision for Shannon is to see that we grow from strength to strength. My vision is to see that every little one, all your grandchildren, all your children, and everybody that belongs to Full Gospel or to any other church, but we know that God has sent every child here. And my involvement has been having amazing staff work for us. God has sent each one through that door. And I just give glory to God that whatever you saw on there is the Lord. That is the Lord. And I want to just say thank you to the Lord for bringing him here under a situation that I would never, ever have been able to do unless what happened, and I give him glory for what happened. So thank you. Yeah.
Amen.
Pastor Oliver, can yes. I just mention that I'm still involved. I visit Margaret on and off and spoil the children. And I have been doing the music, what you are doing now, for Shannon Nurses
yes,
School.
Yes, praise the
concerts.
Lord.
That's good. That's good. So I just want to ask, maybe you have a highlight or two that you would like to just share with the church over the years that you've been involved.
Well, I love children, and I love to work with children. So I find it a great joy to visit Margaret and the children, all the concerts, and in between, as I said, I spoil them with biscuits and sweets.
Marshmallows.
Which is not so good, but a grandmother are allowed to do things like that. So it's been a highlight to be part of the work of the Lord until today.
Margaret, and you, a highlight or two over the last few years that you've been there?
The biggest highlight is that God planted, and the biggest step of faith that we ever took, and Pastor Basil sitting over there, thank you, Lord, that we could open Hope School in Ivory Park. Yes, I just went a bit. We actually opened that school. They broke it down, they built it, we equipped it, we gave them a curriculum at Ivory Park, and to me was the biggest leap of faith, because sometimes we feel we need to hold on to money, the devil's work, but it was just like we had to keep this, and we had to know that we could go forward, that we could do things. But you know, God had another plan, and he allowed us to relax and say, well, okay, fine, we're going to build Ivory Park, not we, God. And we need to, and that was the biggest step of faith for us as and myself at the nursery school. Biggest step of faith.
That's awesome. So I just want to just ask, where are some of the learners now that have passed through the nursery school?
Most of them, I would say almost 80% have gone to Shannon in the years. The others have gone to Tom Newby. We have had quite a few from Tom Newby. But at that stage, too, we had children who had siblings at Tom Newby, and that we had an aftercare here. The aftercare was started round about the same time. So those children's siblings all went to...
Okay, and now where are they? So if they started in 2005 or whatever, yeah. or even before that, yeah. where are they? What are jobs have they got? Do you know of any?
Job wise, no.
Maybe Sister Renge, well, or maybe Denise.
I actually know of two, because I saw the evidence in the video footage. So two of our Shannon Nursery School children are teachers
exactly.
at our school now, and that was Nikita that's hiding away, and Shemay. they were children at the nursery school, but they're actually teachers there now, yeah, so we know what they're doing.
And could I say that if they came from a grounding, a godly grounding at Shannon Nursery School, they are blossoming out there.
Amen. And it's
absolutely.
And it's quite hard to keep track of them once they go into life. And all that, but yeah, I want to ask between Margaret and Denise, what do you see for the future of the ministry?
So I think when Shannon Nursery School started, it was one of the very few nursery schools in the area, and I think if you drive with your eyes wide open around Benoni, you'll see that there's a nursery school now on every corner. And so I've really been asking the Lord, what have you called us to do? We know that there's such a demand for nursery schools because so many of our mommies are working and so many people are looking for a safe place for their children. And the Lord gave me a picture of what the education ministry needs to look like. And that is a picture of a greenhouse. And if you know anything about a greenhouse, it's normally a safe, controlled environment where you've got good nurturing in the soil to enable plants to thrive. And the little part that Shannon Nursery School is responsible for is the germination of those little seeds, where those first few little leaves sprout. And we also know that that's an incredibly vulnerable time in the lives of children. And so we really have to treasure and nurture them. So God has called us to two things, and that is to truly disciple and to educate. And so our focus here at the school going forward is very much making sure that there's that equal balance, that our children are not just getting school ready, because there are lots of places doing that, but that they are getting a solid grounding in God's word. And I accepted Jesus into my life at age 5 in the Sunday school next door. And so I know that we can actually minister salvation to every little child, because they will be with us until the age of 5. And that's really the heart that I see. But yeah, it's just plugging into education in our little space that we've got here, just as God has called us to do.
Could I just quickly add to that? Children's lives and their characters are formed before the age of 6. 6 is basically cut off. Their little characters are formed. And what a privilege it is to be part of forming that character as a godly character, as a foundation that we have. We have an awesome responsibility towards these children. And what Dee says, yes, that little seed has to grow. But by 6 years old, that little character has been formed. So it's a privilege to help form it and to help mold it as we've got there in the pottery. We're helping mold those little lives in Jesus.
Thank you so much, ladies. Appreciate your time up here. We're now going to have a transition period, and the video for Shannon Christian School is going to play while these ladies go off, and when the next, you know who you are, Pastor Basil, Kirsten, and Marlene and Lynette, if you'll come join me up here while the video plays. That's just a bit of a snippet over the last 30 plus years. Denise, I don't know how you put so much, or how you even sift through all that 30 years of information, 30 plus years. But I want to start with Pastor Basil. If you'll just share a bit with us when the vision was first birthed for Shannon Christian School, and when did the ministry start?
Thank you, Pastor Oliver. It's so easy when we look back at our schools to talk about what we have done. But for me, the most profound thing is what God has done in all of this. And when I look back at Shannon Christian School, and if I can just bring 3D in here as well, the vision for Shannon Christian School was birthed in Pastor Smook's heart in 1952 in Kroonstad. And it wasn't until 1989 that the school came into being. And the vision for 3D was birthed in my heart in 1986. And it didn't come to fruition until after 2000, the year 2000. And the thing that I realized through that is that God always finds a torchbearer for whatever he wants to do. But the torch is not lit at the time that he actually places into a person's hands. And it takes years sometimes before that torch is actually lit and you begin to see the effect of the light that flows from that. And that to me has been the profound thing about all of these educational ministries, is that God first finds a person that he can trust to do what he needs done, even when it hasn't come to pass yet. And the question that that leaves with me this morning, that I really believe we need to challenge ourselves with at all times, is what torch has God placed in your hand? Because each one of us has been given an incredible opportunity to walk faithful to something that God wants to do, but it doesn't happen immediately. And I think that in time, if we also look at the scriptures, there are people who were given an opportunity to carry a torch, but because the torch wasn't lit, they cast it aside and did nothing with it. So what does God do? He's faithful. He chooses because he trusts us to be faithful too. And so ask yourself this morning, what has God entrusted to me that has not yet come to pass? And I think in doing that, allow God to inspire you and just say, I'm going to hold on to that. And then the other thing that I've noticed with the education ministries, if I can switch back for a moment to Shannon Nursery School, Pastor Ollie. When Teacher Rachel retired after, and Rachel can correct me, I think it was about 30 years of ministry at the nursery school. What we did for her is we went back to the enrollment register of the nursery school. From the first day that it started, every single child that was enrolled at the school and the year that they enrolled, we compiled into a booklet. And that booklet had the child's name and the year that they were enrolled in the school. And it was in sequence of names, so you could follow it up based on families, or it was also in sequence of date so that you could see all the learners that were together in the class. And Pierre told me later that Rachel would lie in bed at night and she would read through this journal of lives that were touched and changed, and it brought back so many incredible memories for her, because she would see the name of a child and then she would see, oh, yes, the other children that were in the same class in that year. Or she would go to the name and have a look at the family members. And all of these kids that had come through, and what I realized with our education ministries more than anything, is that God trusts us with the lives of young people. And we should take that as educators very, very seriously. That God is placing in your hands a life who, like a piece of clay, needs to be molded. And we heard from Denise and Margaret that formation that takes place in their life. And God has just blessed us incredibly at the house of the Lord that we can be involved with kids from the age of 3 months in the nursery school through to 23 years old in 3D, molding lives of people. And if we are not faithful to what God has entrusted to us, Pastor Oliver, then we cannot expect to get a return on the time and the effort we put in. So 1952 to 1989, before the torch was lit, 1986 to just after 2000, before the torch was lit, and are we faithful to carry that torch until that time? Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pastor Battle. I just want to ask the ladies here, but maybe we'll just start with Kirsten and move our way on, but what is one of the biggest highlights over the last, I don't know how many years you've been involved in Shannon, but what is maybe one or two of the highlights that you have over the years?
One of the highlights that sprung to mind immediately when we were on a mission trip to Zambia and you were part of it, we sat in this combi miles away from the nearest town and the petrol tank was on empty. And we had everyone that was sitting in that quantum, the learners, praying that we would get to the nearest town. And we traveled on empty, must have been about over 100 kilometers. And that was an incredible, incredible experience for me to see the entire, they just went silent and then they prayed. And we got to the garage and it was totally empty. And that experience was just amazing. The other highlights, there's just so many, but the African, All Africa Student Convention is just amazing to see how many children discovered their God-given talents and were able to develop them. And it's a convention where a lot of students from Christian schools come together and they compete against each other. But out of that grew so much because we had lots of worship team leaders arising from their children who realized they had a talent in singing or in some instrument. And I look back now and they've become worship leaders wherever they are. And that those things are just so amazing to me. So there's many stories, but yeah.
Marlene?
One highlight, that's very difficult. I can't.
I'll give you two.
That's not enough either. I need at least 30 because I've been at Shannon for 30 years. I think to me, every day is a highlight. When you work with the learners, and it's just so special, Pastor Basil said, the parents entrust the children's lives to us, and that's true. You know, it's not just teaching a child in a learning center. It's actually teaching the child 24 hours of your life, because it's the way you walk, it's the way you talk, it's what you do, and also what you don't do that leaves an impression on learners. And but yes, the highlight for me is always when there are celebrations happening, like our 10th year celebration. And can you believe me that when we had our 10th year celebration, we filled the entire town hall? It was such a very special occasion. I think, Brenda, you were there as well. And we had our leaders from the national office there as well. That was a celebration, not because of a celebration, but because of God's faithfulness. to show us for real, we are there to stay. We're not just a Christian school. We are in God's kingdom, and we are there to stay. And then 21 years happened, and 30 years happened. And to me, it's just God saying, yes, you are doing the right thing. You've been called to do this. Continue to do this. And then my involvement in Shannon Christian School didn't just start in 1989 when the school started. This is just my testimony. I think I've been involved in Christian education for 68 years. And I can say that because I was born in 1952. That is when Pastor Billy got the vision of Christian education. And I do believe that God's got a plan and a purpose for each and every one of us. And doesn't matter how old we are, God has got his plan, and he will fulfill that plan no matter what.
Denise, I'm going to skip you for now, but Lynette, if you can just share maybe one or two highlights of your time.
She's been skipped. I agree with Marlene. Every day is a highlight when you arrive at school and the children run to meet you. You feel a bit like a celebrity. I do. It's so wonderful to be able to step onto our ground, and a lot of the parents who's come in have testified that they just feel the peace. They can feel God there, and we have the privilege of being there every day. And in those quiet times, that's a highlight. But when the children arrive and you hear the laughter and the noise that they make, it's a joyful noise unto the Lord, and it's beautiful. So that is a highlight every day for me. I think one of the other highlights that stood out for me was to watch the miracle of building the faith hall. There was no money, but every day it got built. And there it stands today. And all the parents that I take on walkabouts, I mean, there's a testimony right there, which is a highlight that's forever there. And it attests to God's faithfulness.
Amen. Thank you so much. I want to now just ask Marlene and Kirsten, maybe, and this is an easier question than the nursery school, but where are some of our learners now that have passed through Shannon Christian School?
Well, we are blessed to say that one of the learners is sitting right here. And he's now questioning me.
She was my principal.
And I've got to listen and obey to him. That is wonderful. It's such a very special privilege. But Pastor Oliver, we've got quite a few pastors around, I can almost say around the world. So we've got quite a few pastors, and that to me is a blessing. What to me is also a blessing is that we've got, same as Shannon Nursery School, we've got some staff members at the school that have gone through Shannon, and they are now staff members at the school. And let me tell you, they are so good, because the learners can never get away with anything. No shortcuts, because they know all the shortcuts. And then we really have in all walks of life, we've got our learners standing out in their communities and wherever they are. We are also blessed to have one of our learners serving on the school board. We've got a pilot, we've got a medical doctor, we've got so many of them, we've got sportsmen, we've got quite a few people that's just fulfilling their God calling as well. I leave some of them to you.
If I can mention for a moment, one of the learners from Shannon Christian School is a man by the name of Thabo Mdluli, and he's a very well-known TV personality today in South Africa. And if you tune into one of the news programs, one of the news channels on DSTV, he's a presenter on the news channel as well. And he was a presenter for a long time on One Gospel channel. And these are the kind of people that have come out of Shannon Christian School and went on to, quote, make a name for themselves, but have really made a name for what we do as a church in terms of education.
one of our graduates actually is responsible for that artwork over there. So it's very special to see.
And that artwork over
and
there.
And that artwork over
and
there.
And a whole bunch of artwork.
And yeah, I've always been very privileged to see them graduate, finish off school with me, and I've seen many, and it's just such a privilege to see them come back and say hello and tell me where they are with God and what are they doing with their life. So privileged am I, and God is so faithful.
I now want to just go to Denise and Lynette, but what do you see for the future of Shannon moving forward?
So I touched on this picture that God's given me about the greenhouse, and I was thinking about how all our ministries fit together. And when you get to Shannon Christian School, I think that's the season for me where I really want to see each one of the little plants in our greenhouse begin to bear some flowers or fruit. And what I've reminded the staff is, in your greenhouse, you also have to have a cactus or two as well. So we have to give space in our school for our learners to be individuals. And we actually offer individualized Christian education, which is one of the things that makes Shannon so unique using the ACE system. But it really is my heart's desire to see us nurture the individualness of our children. But the other side as well is we have to create a safe space for children. We are watching in the media and in news about all the crises that are happening in schools. And we are committed to, in the way that we respond as educators, but in the environment that we provide, to truly keep our children safe spiritually, emotionally, and even physically as well. And then going forward as well, it's the same vision as the nursery school, is to give an equal focus to God's word. Because what good is it if our children have an academic education, but there's no character? And so at Shannon, we absolutely prioritize character. So we are known as quite a strict school, and we have rules and regulations, and we enforce our rules and regulations because kids have to learn boundaries, and that's actually how they stay safe. So we want to continue with the work God has given us, which is that equal focus on discipleship as well as education, not neglecting either one of those. We have many schools in our community that are Christian in ethos, but they're not Christian in terms of the fundamental day-by-day procedures and processes. And I think that's what makes Shannon different, is that we are fundamentally based on God's word. So my heart's desire is to really continue with the vision God has given us, and to do it with all our heart, and to trust him to send exactly the right learners. A picture that I've seen a lot in the last little while in my own mind is little broken or damaged plants, or plants that are not thriving out in the elements, and how they have to come into the greenhouse to be restored. And so that's what we're trusting God for, is to begin to send more of those kind of learners as well that really need a space, and even families that need a space to be able to mend and heal and develop confidence in our school.
What do I say after that? To add to that. Oh, my prayer has always been that we can just see children the way God sees them, to see his plan, and to blossom them into his plan that he has for them. So my vision for the future is just to always stay obedient.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. I think we could sit here for the whole day with each of our ministries, but we've come to the end of our time with Shannon Christian School. So Denise and Pastor Basil, if you'll just stay up here, but the rest of you can go. And then if you can just play that video for 3D Academy. Thank you.
It's a new day. Make a move, doing things a new way. A new way. Cause this is our world, and this is our time. These are our plans. We're gonna let them shine. this is our place in the human race. And we won't stop dreaming. No, we won't stop dreaming. Look ahead.
Down to guide you, speak to you, and everything you need.
See how far we've come over mountains through valleys.
That was me in my wild days, but yeah, so many memories when you go through all these things. But Pastor Basil, you've shared with us a bit about 3D's vision as well. But maybe if you can touch a bit more on that and where that whole vision came from for a finishing year.
Thank you, Pastor Oliver. The amazing thing about God planting stuff in your heart is that it normally comes in the form of whatever your character is, because God speaks to engineers in engineering terms, and he speaks to educationalists in education terms, and worshipers in terms of worshiping terms. And the thing that fascinated me when this vision first formed is God had given me a fascination for the finishing schools that were renowned in Switzerland. And they started off as society mechanisms for taking young women out of school and finishing them off so that they could enter into the social life of the European hierarchy at that stage. But the concept of finishing off is the part that really stuck with me. And in my own experiences in business, I met many top executives and always asked them this question: when did you get into this line of business in which you are and in which you have become a success? And the answer was inevitably after the age of 25. And the reason for that was that between the age of 20 or leaving school and 25, young people battle to find what they were actually birthed for. They battle to find that thing that God created inside of them. And so the net result is that they spend the early 20 years searching, and sometimes at the expense of parents, in the sense that parents put them into a university or a college or whatever, thinking that this is what this child needs to do. And then the child ends up finding out that that's not what they want to do, and they change course, and it's a year wasted, and it's a year's tuition fees wasted, and then they change course again, and then sometimes they leave with a degree and they end up in the workplace, and ending up in the workplace, it takes a couple of years, and then suddenly they find out this is where they need to be. So with that knowledge, this vision of a finishing school was birthed on the basis of, if we can give a child 5 years of life experience in 1 year, then we're going to take them at the age of 20 and literally put them where they would be at the age of 25 so that they can make the quality decision that they need to make. But then, of course, in that process, also connecting them with God in such a way that they hear what He made them for. The Bible teaches us that when we were formed in our mother's womb, God had His eye on us. He already had a plan and a purpose for us, and we need to find that. So the establishment, Pastor Oliver, was with those two goals in mind: to take a young person, A, finish them off in terms of their character, and B, prepare them for what God has called them to be in the future. And for me, the incredible realization of being involved with 3D has been to see lives absolutely transformed in a year. And the interesting thing is just that the thing that finishes our character and forms us is what's called new life experiences. Every time you and I have a new life experience, that adds to our worldview and the way we see things. And so what we do is, if the average child has one new life experience in a month, then what we want to do is give them five new life experiences in a month, and that should transition them over a five-year period, I mean, in a one-year period, over 5 years of experience. So the kids get involved in doing all sorts of things that give them those new life experiences. And they gain an incredible confidence. They gain an incredible knowledge of themselves. So that has been the vision. And the blessing that I've had being involved with that is just to watch these young people's lives absolutely transformed in a year. You cannot believe the person that you meet at the beginning of the year and the person that leaves at the end of the year. I'm going to give you one very brief example, if I may, Pastor Oliver. One of our very early students was a young girl that came from Bloemfontein. She had never in her life left Bloemfontein. She didn't know what the rest of South Africa looked like. And she enrolled quite late in the program, so we made a decision to actually fly her up from Bloemfontein so that she could get here in time. And when she got on the plane, it was the first time she'd ever been on an aeroplane. So her life was already incredibly transformed just having this experience. And she landed here the day before campus actually opened. So We couldn't send her to the campus, so Finney and I took her into our home so that she could stay the night with us and be ready to go into the campus the next day, only to find out that she had never experienced the ability to open a hot or a cold tap and open a hot tap and get hot water out of a hot tap. And that kind of thing is like in 2 days just life transforming, because you're experiencing stuff you've never experienced before. And I believe that that's what 3D gives the young people that come there. Thanks.
Thank you, Pastor Bethel. So so Denise was our first dean of the 3D Revelation campus. So if you can just tell us a bit about when did it start, how many students did we have, and maybe just a bit about that.
So the doors opened in 2008, January of 2008, and our goal was 10 students. I'm very optimistic always about life. And we had one student, not 10. And it was actually Levo's son, Mpo. But I've been told by the team that it was like having 10 students. Because Mpo's like a real treasure and a handful at the same time. And we had 5 staff members. I mean, man, that's individualized, boy, when there's 5 people just catering to one person's needs. But we ended up putting Sandy and Oliver as team leaders actually through the whole program at the same time. So they were sort of learning on the job. And the program's always grown slowly. God has always just sent us a few at a time. The most students we've ever had in one intake was 12. And, you know, we've always wanted to have 20 or 40, you know, these big numbers. But we realize when you walk a road the way we do at 3D that the individualized small group actually is quite important. But I think to date we've probably graduated just over 70 young people. And we truly get to see the fruit of the next step. So Shannon Nursery School, it's quite hard to know where the little ones are. But we have such an amazing connection still to our graduates. And that's incredibly exciting, because often they just phone us when they want marriage advice, or when they want work advice, or when they want me just still to check a CV 10 years later, I get an email. But yeah, so we remain really connected to them, which is wonderful as well.
Okay, and maybe just share one or two highlights over the years that you've had.
I actually want to throw something in here across the ministries, and that is the privilege that I've had of having my own children involved in all 3 programs. So my eldest daughter was not in the nursery school. We started Boxburg at the time, but I'll pick on Bronnie today because she was hosting. And so that's a product of the education ministry at the House of the Lord. I can proudly say that. and she's married another product of our education ministry, which is extra wonderful as well. But you know what? It's you can do for everyone else's children, but it's very profound when somebody or something does for your own children. Particularly when you're a family involved in ministry, man, poor children. Yeah, I mean, anyone that's involved in the ministry, you know, your poor kids. And God has given us just really 2 treasures of daughters that have gone through Shannon Christian School as well and through 3D. And so my highlight, very selfishly right here, is the fruit that I see in the lives of my children that I had nothing or no part actually of doing. And so I want to honor the educators, because for me, what you've done for my family is what makes me truly privileged to be part of this ministry.
And Jules, as a new dean, if you'll just share a highlight or two over the last few years that you've been involved in.
I think my first highlight starts at the end of 2012, where I needed to make a big decision of, am I going back to what I call Egypt, but which is home, but stay in God's promised land, Israel. But there was, 10 students coming that January, and at the campus, Dee had said, we're transforming the house, and we're needing 75,000 rand to renovate and turn the lounge and the dining room which was the music room, into the dining room now, and just put a coffee.com area. And I saw the faith of the church just giving more than the 75,000 rand. And just that was a really big highlight for 3D stepping in faith there. And then just recently last year when I had a wrestle with God and I said, okay, right, we've been praying since 2013. What's next? We need to move. And I think the going statement has always been, we're going to have our own campus when we outgrow our capacity. And our God doesn't work like business principles. His growth isn't always up. Sometimes it's deep. Sometimes it's wide. Sometimes it's just not what we expect. And it was getting the new permanent campus that we have. That's the second highlight.
Awesome. Denise, what would you say is one of the biggest leaps of faith that you needed to take in 3D over the years?
You know what, I think it's maybe also speaking a little bit of a deeper work. So 3D, I used to call it my baby, and anyone that's pioneered a ministry will know what that means. And the time in which God said, surrender your baby to me. This is not supposed to be your baby. This is God's baby. And again, the torch that we carry is just a torch. And, you know, you think you've laid something down. And then when the stress comes and you realize how much you haven't laid it down because you're still stressing about it. And it was really a turning point for me a couple of years ago. And it came through the Dreamgiver series where there's a part that Bruce Wilkinson talks about. And he says that you go into this place called Sanctuary. And at the top, God says, lay the dream down. And you leave that place very empty because you're like, what do I do now? I've relinquished this. But when you come down off the mountain, you find the dream at the bottom. And then God says, you are no longer the owner of the dream, but now you are just a steward of the dream. And I realized that process needed to happen so that I could even get out of the way to let Jules step in because I'm kind of a bit of a control freak. I don't know if we have other control freaks out there. I like to keep my fingers in the pie. And God just said, step back, and to be able to trust Jules to take over and to run with it. And through Jules and the work that he's doing, God has provided that next thing that I was trusting God for since 2008, God provided to him and through him when I kind of got out the way. So I think it's been that process of actually just watching 3D become God's and not D's, and that's been important.
Maybe if you can just spend a few moments just speaking about where some of the students are that have come through. So there's 70 of them, but maybe just like two or three or four of them. Where are they?
I think with everyone that I've been involved in, it's, as I can say, David says in Psalms 27 verse 4, one thing that I desire, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. So can I ask all the 3D students just make a noise? There's a whole section of them, and a lot of them are in the house of the Lord, serving in the different ministries. We have G-Man as a fur fighter, almost. We have Justin down in Richards Bay. He's a chartered accountant now, so he's working. We have Tyler as owning our own business. George in Zimbabwe. He's a police officer. The Fatwa also in Zimbabwe. He's in the economic crisis that Zimbabwe had, which was really fantastic at the time, is he went and applied for a job at three companies, and he got all three jobs, and he picked the one closest to home. So he's an accountant at the post office in Zimbabwe. And just in the time that it was been so hectic, where he could still get three jobs using the skills that he's applied. And yeah, they everywhere in South Africa.
And then maybe just to close off, this is from Julio. What do you see the future of 3D?
I think I'm gonna share connecting with the greenhouse concept. Our vision is to plant the disciples that comes through the ministry, to plant them. But my heart is to see this program grow and touch more people and young people in South Africa. So it's the hope for four campuses in and around South Africa. We've started a good relationship, and God is starting to answer more prayers. It's in KZN with Pastor Andre Smook. That's the one. The next one, we're hoping for Bloemfontein and somewhere in the Cape, whether it be Eastern or Western Capes. And that's where I see this program growing to. The I had a conversation with the Lord this week and saying, you know, we want the 40s, but you've given us to keep it at 12 at a time, doing the discipleship work. So let's multiply this program into the country. And that's where there's 4 campuses in and around the country, and keep it as intimate as it is, because we see the fruits and the results from that.
Thank you so much. That's really exciting. Denise, I want to just ask that you, as Director of Education, would just put in a summary from Shannon Nursery School all the way to 3D, just that vision that you have.
So, yeah, we're all about discipling and educating, those two things in equal measure. We believe that there's 3 learning areas, and that is academic learning and godly learning and experiential learning. And then God, in our picture of our greenhouse, has given us a roof, a covering, and it's 4 words: love, God, learn, and grow. That's the culture of what we're doing. And so we are privileged to really do individualized work. And we thank you so much as a house of the Lord for the way in which you support us, the way in which you love our kids, and the way in which you just love us. You know, we had the opening of 3D the other day, and so many people came. We have Christmas carols at Shannon Christian School, and so many of you come to that. So we are so blessed to be plugged into a church that really cares. And we really love you, and we thank you that you love us back. And to all our educators that serve, I have seen one thing over the last 2 years as Director of Education, is that we do not have our schools populated with teachers that are looking for a good salary, but our educators are there because they believe they're called. And because they're called, we see the fruit of the work that they do in the lives of our children.
I just want to add something in here. It costs us in the region of 75,000 Rand per year to have one student at 3D, complete a year at 3D. That is accommodation, food, materials, everything that they need. And 2 highlights for me over the years was when we gained our first family sponsorship, where a family in the house of the Lord said, I want to sponsor a student for the year that lies ahead, and selected one student and said, I'm going to pay the fees, because we do not charge a student anything beyond what they can afford. So some students actually attend 3D for as little as 200 Rand a month, when in fact the cost is 75,000 Rand over the year. And then the second highlight, Pastor Ali, was when we got our first corporate sponsor. And I want to encourage you, if you know of any corporation who wants to invest in the youth of our country and make a difference in the life of one person who cannot afford to go to a university or a college or anything like that, and you know and have some kind of influence, put them in contact with us, because that is what drives this program effectively. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And thank you, Dee, for joining me up stage for all these different things. Now, let's give all these people a hand that have just helped me share the story of our ministries. At this time, I want to ask that all... everyone here involved in education, whether it's in these ministries or whether it's Boxburg Christian Academy and you're involved as a principal or a teacher there, if you'll come join us up front here, and even if you're involved in a music school, a dull, wherever you are, if you'll come join us up front here. But anyone who's involved in education of any form, if you'll come join us up front here, we just want to dedicate you to the Lord for the work that he has called you to. So don't be too shy, because you are all teachers. So, and also our children's church teachers, you're also involved in education and discipleship, so it's so great to have you all here. Is there anyone else that's hiding that should be up here, involved in education? So we just want to give you something just to remind you a bit about what it is that you are called to. So we're going to give you this certificate. It says they're dedicated to be used by God in the transformation of individuals through education. And our theme scripture for this year, which is Romans 12 verse 2, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. And that you need for your life, you need transformation for your life, but you are involved in the transformation of others' lives. So, I just want to ask that us as a church, if we'll just stand and actually just stretch out our hands towards them as we just dedicate them to the Lord for the work that lies ahead for them. Thank you for what you do. Thank you for how you disciple. Thank you for how you've taken the Great Commission. And through education, you are busy making disciples. You are growing the kingdom of God. I know that it's not easy. And some mornings you wake up and you're just like, Lord, what am I doing? But thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your perseverance. And we want to honor you this morning for what you do and for what you continue to do. So let's pray. Lord, we thank you for these teachers, Lord, and these people involved in education. Lord, it's actually just a humbling experience, Lord, to know that our church can be involved, Lord, in just impacting the next generation and impacting the education system, Lord, in our country, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. And I pray, Lord, for each of these teachers here right now, Lord. And I dedicate them to you, Lord, to be used by you and for your glory. Lord, I ask, Lord, that the testimonies that they've had up to now, Lord, that you will just do greater and even more abundantly what they could ever ask or even imagine, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for the transformation that is happening in their hearts, but I thank you for the transformation that is also happening in the learners and the students under them, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for each little bit of transformation that happens in their lives, Lord, and we praise you and we give you glory for this, Lord. So we dedicate them, we set them apart to be used by you, Lord. I pray for perseverance, I pray for faithfulness, I pray for strength, Lord, and I pray, Lord, that the enemy will not steal from them, Lord, but whatever the enemy has stolen, Lord, that you will just give back, Father, hundredfold, Father, into their lives and into their ministries, Lord. I pray, Lord, that they will not grow weary in doing good, Lord, but in due season they will reap, Lord, if they do not faint, Lord. So we thank you for this, Lord, and we bless them. We pray for your favor, your supernatural favor to rest upon them, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, that we are going to see a mighty wave of the next generation rising up of God lovers, God fearers, and people that are educated in the way that you want them to be educated. So we thank you for this in Jesus' name. Amen.